Nice to see you once again. I welcome you all. I welcome you in the name of the Lord. So I want you to listen to this. Just listen to this. I want to tell you what is going on right now in Nigeria. I want to read it in the Word of God for you to know what God is doing and what is going on in Nigeria. In Nigeria, that's why you need to pray. We need to pray without ceasing. We need to pray now. If we want to take it back, we need to pray. We need to engage in battle. We need to engage in warfare. I don't know whether I've received the prayer point that I sent. Join. It's a war. It's a warfare. Something is going on. Listen to what I want to read for you now, for you to know clearly what is going on in the realm of the spirit in Nigeria concerning coming election. Just listen. I want to read something for you right now. In the book of Joshua chapter 10. Joshua chapter 10 from verse 1. I just want to read and I will explain to you. Just listen. Now, Joshua chapter 10 from verse 1. Now it came to pass when Adoni Zedek, king of Jerusalem, this is a pastor, a bishop, or an apostle, or a prophet, no? King of Jerusalem. Jerusalem means church. Now it came to pass when Adoni Zedek, king of Jerusalem, heard how Joshua had taken Ai and had utterly destroyed it, as he had done to Jericho and its king. So he had done to Ai and its king, and how the inhabitants of Gibeon had made peace with Israel and were among them, that they feared greatly because Gibeon was a great city, like one of the royal cities, and because it was greater than Ai, and all its men were mighty. Therefore, Adoni Zedek, king of Jerusalem, pastors in Nigeria, listen very carefully, pastors in Nigeria, I'm talking about evil pastors in Nigeria that is more deadly and more wicked than Nigerian politicians, than their politicians. They are afraid that if truly won this election, that they are in trouble. So listen to what they are doing. Adoni Zedek is the king of Jerusalem, his pastor, his bishop, he's a fake pastor, fake bishop, fake apostle, fake prophet, fake teachers, fake children of God. Listen carefully. Listen. Therefore, Adoni Zedek, king of Jerusalem, sent to Huham, king of Hebron. They are calling other kings, like calling all the kings, presidents, all of them, calling all the other president, all the ex-presidents of Nigeria, all the people that think that they have mouth, or they are renowned men, or they are famous, or they are just listen. I don't want to waste. Take your time. Therefore, Adoni Zedek, king of Jerusalem, sent to Huham, king of Hebron, Piram, king of Jamot, Japhia, king of Lachish, and Debir, king of Egron, saying, there are five. The churches is the one that summoned all these ones to come. They had a closed door meeting because of what they are saying. They are conspiring, they are gathering, they are not sleeping, they are having a meeting. The pastors have summoned, they said, people, come, let us team together and know how to stop this young man. Come up to me. The church is the problem of Nigeria. The church is the problem of Africa. God said, thus says the Lord, Bible, Africa as a whole. The problem we are facing is the fake church, the fake pastors, the fake bishops, the fake men of God. They are the problem. They are the real enemy of the great country of Africa, of the great country of Nigeria. Are you hearing what I'm saying to you? This thing I'm reading now is the church that first of all call other kings to come and help them to fight one man, to fight Joshua and the children of God. Come up, verse 4 says, come up to me and help me, that we may attack Gibeah, that we may attack AAC, that we may attack Mr. Sowore, for it has made peace with Joshua and with the children of Israel. Therefore, the five kings of the Amorites, the king of Jerusalem, the king of Hebron, the king of Jarmuth, the king of Lachish, and the king of Egron, gathered together and went up, they and all their armies, and they camped before Gibeah, and made war against it, and made war against the supporters, people that is supporting Joshua, all the people that see that Joshua is truly powerful, is truly from God. Gibeah is a royal city. They join Joshua. They choose to join Israel. They made peace. They say, no, we cannot join to fight Joshua and his men. Let us join them because we have seen good. So many people have seen that AAC, the Sowore, is good. So many people have joined the crew, joined the colors. Because, but there are evil conspiracy that we have to scatter. And the thing is started from the church, the evil church, wicked church. They are calling other wicked kings, wicked presidents that have ruled before, and they don't want that country to be good. So the pastors that is evil and the bloodsuckers, they are all thing together now. But I want to do this for you to understand. And made war against it, you know. And I'm reading verse 6. And the men of Gibeah sent to Joshua at the camp at Gilgal, saying, do not forsake your servant. Come up to us quickly. Save us and help us. For all the kings of the Amorites who dwell in the mountains, have gathered together against us. So Joshua ascended from Gilgal, he and all the people of war with him, and all the mighty men of valor. And the Lord said to Joshua, do not fear them. The Lord said to us, said to AAC, do not fear. And the Lord said to Joshua, and the Lord said to me, and the Lord said to his loving children, to his children that love him. And God says to AAC, and the Lord said to us, do not fear them. For I have delivered them into your hand. Not a man of them shall stand before you. Joshua, therefore, came upon them suddenly, having marched all night from Gilgal. So the Lord routed them before Israel, killed them with a great slaughter at Gibeah, chased them along the road that goes to Beth Holon, and struck them down as far as Azekah and the Makeda. And it happened as they fled before Israel, and were on the descent of Beth Holon, that the Lord cast down large hailstones from heaven on them as far as Azekah, and they died. There was more who died from the hailstone than the children of Israel killed with the sword. Then Joshua spoke to the Lord in the day when the Lord delivered up the Amorites before the children of Israel, and he said in the sight of Israel, sun stands still over Gibeah, and the moon in the valley of Ajalon. So the sun stood still and the moon stopped till the people had revenge upon their enemies. Listen very carefully. I want to make it short. But these five kings, had fled, the evil kings see that the battle is so hot that God is busy fighting for his people. As Joshua and his children, as the children of God, the army of God and the children of God, you know, they gather and face the evil. As we gather and face the evil, can you see what God can do? As we gather and combat with this evil, God will fight for us. God will be in the battle. God will fight for us. God, heaven, we descend. They will hear our voice. They will fight the evil in Nigeria for us. But these five kings had fled and hidden themselves in a cave at Makeda. And it was told Joshua, saying, the five kings have been found hidden in the cave at Makeda. But Joshua said, roll a large stone against the mouth of the cave, and set men by it to guard them. And do not stay there yourself, but pursue your enemies and attack their rear guard. Do not allow them to enter their cities, for the Lord your God has delivered them into your hands. Then it happened while Joshua and the children of Israel made an end of slaying them with a very great slaughter till they had finished, that those who escaped entered fortified city, and all the people returned to camp to Joshua at Makeda in peace. No one moved his tongue against any of the children of Israel. Then Joshua said, open the mouth of the cave and bring out those five kings to me from the cave. And they did so and brought out those evil kings. And they did so and brought out those five kings to him from the cave, the king of Jerusalem, pastors, the king of Hebron, the king of Jarmuth, the king of Lachish, and the king of Eglon. So it was when they brought out those kings to Joshua that Joshua called for all the men of war who went with him. Come near, put your feet on the necks of these kings. And they drew near and put their feet on their necks. Then Joshua said to them, do not be afraid, nor be dismayed. Be strong and of good courage, for thus the Lord will do to all your enemies against whom you fight. And afterward, Joshua struck them and killed them and hanged them on five trees. And they were hanged on the tree until evening. So it was at the time of the going down of the sun that Joshua commanded, and they took them down from the trees, cast them into the cave where they had been hidden, and lay large stone against the cave's mouth, which remains until this very day. Did you just hear what I read now? This is the word of God. All the people that is conspiring, all the people that hate that country, all the enemies of that country that claim that that nation belongs to them, that nobody will take it away from them. All the evil pastors, they are the king of Jerusalem, the church, as I said to you, they are the number one, the evil churches in Nigeria, in Africa. They are the real enemy. They are the enemy that are supposed to protect, shelter, shepherd, nurture, care, protect the people, the citizens, and they command the authorities to do good. Instead, they are the one that is calling to come and let us do evil. Let us do evil. Let us fight against anything good that wants to happen in that nation or in that continent. But God will punish them. I decree God's judgment. I decree shame and disgrace. I decree calamity upon any man or any woman in Africa, in the continent of Africa, in the country of Nigeria, that is busy thinking and devising and plotting evil for Nigeria and for Africa at large, or the whole world. There is no room for evil anymore. You see how God fought with Joshua. This is how children of God are supposed to be. Not afraid to attack the enemy, not afraid to face them, because when you are doing so, God will be with you, God will use you to fight God will use you. If you make yourself available, you become a hurricane. You become a hurricane. You become an atomic power. You become become a weapon. You become a dangerous weapon in the hand of God that God will use to crush and eliminate evil. Look at how Joshua and the children of Israel and the armies of and the children of God, they faced the enemy. They faced the enemy and eliminated them. God is busy fighting through them. God is busy. God, you know, is busy empowering them. God empowered them, loaded them, hearing their cry, their prayer. When they say, moon, stand, sun, stand, sun, stand. Because they are doing the right thing. They are doing the counsel of God. And the children of Israel, the children of God, these days, you are busy. You fold your hands, looking like mumu. You can't back. Your pastors cannot back. Cannot see the evil and talk. They can't even you know, engage them in battle or in fight. They are kidding and they close their mouths. They are stealing themselves because they are number one. They are number one killers. Your pastors are busy killing. The Christians are busy killing. You close your mouth as God's children. They are busy stealing. You say, let them keep stealing. You know, touch not my and my anointed. And do my prophets no harm. You go, no, that you know, no, they do not judge. No, you busy. This is what you are. This is the word of, because you, I don't know what to say. Bible says you should not judge. Close your mouth. Don't judge. But you see Joshua and the children of Israel fighting and killing the enemy, eliminating the enemy. And we are saying, God said we should, even Joshua, you know. And the armies of the children of Israel, they slaughtered the kings of Israel, of Jerusalem, the king of Hebron, the king of Eglon, the king of Lachish. All of them was slaughtered because they are evil. If you see anybody carrying Bible, prophesying, speaking in the name of the Lord, lying to the people, killing the people, and you know that they are evil, they don't wish good, they don't wish you good, they don't wish your nation good, they don't wish your family good, why can't you face them? Why can't you face them? Oh, touch not my anointed, and do my prophet no harm. Even when you see, you catch your pastor, you know, or fornicating, or doing evil, you say, oh, touch not my anointed and do my prophet no harm. You see your pastor going to Asolok, they are giving him bribe. He's taking bribe from them, from the occultic politicians, and he's buying them. Say, oh, don't talk, close your eyes, touch not my anointed and do my prophet no harm. And you see them, they will tell you, remove your clothes, remove everything, go home naked. Okay, sir, touch not my anointed and do my prophet no harm. You are going home naked. And they wear the most expensive clothes. They will tell you, drop your car, drop your key card, drop your house, walk away, go and be sleeping in the bush. You say, yes, sir, touch not my... This is not what God said. You don't know the Bible. You don't know the word of God. Ignorance is a disease. It's a disease. They have hypnotized you, brainwashed you. You know, you are down children. It's not the tune of God is supposed to be fire. You are the highest weapon that's supposed to, that is, to be crushing and destroying and putting down the strongholds and eliminating evil in the realm of the spirit. You are fire. God have loaded you. And you, Bible said that a sinner is running when nobody is pursuing him. But a righteous man is as bold as a lion. So why is the Christians or the church of God these days, or the anointed, or the said that they don't understand the anointed, why are you now like a cat? Even a cat is even better than Christians these days. They go, meow, meow. This is what Christians are doing. Meow. No backing. Come back. When a Christian is talking, he's talking, even the cat, the voice of a cat is more powerful than the voice of a Christian. They have reduced you to a beggar, reduced you to nothing, because you don't know your right, you don't know what the word of God said, you don't know left and right, you don't know the word of your father, you don't know how your father operates. That's why the evil is busy carrying dominion. they turn it. The Muslim, the evil Muslim people, you know, they pick up what God said. Even they turn, they are the now slaughtering Christians, carrying dominion. And the Christian is saying, oh, we should not judge, we should not fight. Vengeance belongs to God. When a lion roar in a place, every other animal hide. You just hear his voice. Every animal disappear. With the voice of Christians.
Meow, meow.
This is the voice of Christians these days. When devil hear that, devil know that that fear have finished this one. Okay, I don't want to take your time so much. You are a lion. I'm a lion. Jesus said that he's the lion of the tribe of Judah. Jesus said, I am the lion of the tribe of Judah. When Jesus rise up, before even he speak, every devil and demon hide. Who is your master? Who are you serving? Are you behaving like your father? Are you a beggar? Is your voice terrorizing the enemy or the enemy terrorizing you? Whose father are you? Who is your father? God, that I know that when he speak thunder, when he get angry, his voice shake the whole world. You have to know this. And I want to tell you, you're not, stop being a cat, be a lion. Be a lion. God bless you. We are not called to be a beggar. We are created by God to function in his authority and to speak under the authority that God has bestowed upon our life and eliminate all evil in the whole world. When we speak, God will pick up our voice and begin to do it. God is waiting for you to back, to roar as a lion you are. Okay, God bless you. And remember this. See you.